Welcome back to Hoochos. Today on Hoochos, we're gonna build this. This is a multimedia NFT hydroponic system. Let's get to building it. So with this system, what I'm trying to accomplish is versatility across peat pellets, net cups, pucks, and rock wool as well, since we just recently figured out how to get rock wool starter plugs for just 2.5 cents each in this video. So I'll show you what you need. So today I'll be using a drill with a 51 millimeter 2-inch hole saw. I'll be using some cable ties to secure the tubing. The tubing I'll be using, this is 19 millimeter and 13 millimeter flex tube, and I'll just be adapting those with the appropriate fittings. In those fittings, make sure you grab some inline barbed taps so that we can control the flow on each channel. I'll be using a heat gun to heat up this PVC and mold it to the shapes that I want. You'll need your square gutter pipe. Now, this is 100 millimeters by 50 millimeters. For the support for my system, I'll be using this scaffolding. It was just something I picked up cheap and it'll do my purposes just fine. You can use star pickets, or you can make a custom frame. However you want to hold these pipes off the ground, it's up to you. You'll also need a pump. Now, people ask me about what pumps I use all the time. This is the larger pump that I upgraded to. It's a bit overkill, but it is the AP3000. So if you want to emulate this system, use this pump, or you will get away with a lot smaller pump. So this is the AP750 LV, which is low voltage. So it runs off 12 volts. You can also use this on a solar powered system with a battery. And that just comes with an AC adapter that adapts to your 12 volt. And this is my res. You've seen it before. It's from my old system. It holds 750 liters. Well and truly overkill for this situation, but it's really good to have that extra capacity if you are going to be leaving the system for any amount of time. All right, now we're going to drill our holes in our PVC. Now we're gonna stagger them. So every second pipe, then you'll have a plant here, and in the next one, it'll be slightly off on a diagonal, which will mean that the plants are spaced and distributed more evenly. The spacing depends on the species of plant you're planning on growing. So there's no size fits all, this is what you should do. Use the plants that you're growing as a guide for the spacing. And because this system isn't going to be a fixed system, you can move the channels around. You can adapt the distance between these channels so that if you have larger plants in one channel and smaller plants in the other, you can give one channel more room than the others. You can also have a couple of propagation channels where you space the holes a lot closer together and have smaller plants that you then move over into the channels with larger spacing. It all depends on how you want to set up your system. So I'm going to make the holes 20 centimeters apart, which is 8 inches apart. And that's purely because I only plan on growing leafy greens in this system. So they don't need too much space and I should get away with it. So I'm just gonna mark those holes out and then we'll drill them out. So starting 10, then another 20. Start in forward and then into reverse. Okay. So now using a heat gun, we're going to heat up the end closest to the res and we're going to bend it so that it gives a lip, which lets the water flow off into the res in a nice manner. When you're heating up the plastic, just go slow and get it nice and thoroughly heated up without burning it. And then we can use a pair of multi-grips to bend the PVC once it's hot enough. So I just used a pair of multi-grips to give that lip. And at the other end, we're gonna fold it up so the water can't escape back out. All right, I'm gonna set up the grow bed another time. Now it's time to run the pump and irrigation up to the top end of the system. So find the amount of irrigation piping that you want to achieve, and then we're going to put an elbow going down into the res so we don't get any kinks, and the appropriate amount of hose down to our pump. So depending on the type of pump you've got, you'll have a adjustment. So you've got on the front here, there's a turnable adjustment that's plus and minus. So it's better to go a little bit bigger than you need and then adjust the flow rate down. Now, I've discussed flow rate in one of my videos already. And in that video, the ideal general flow was given at 2 liters per minute. However, it's more nuanced than that, and it depends on the size of your rail and how much nutrient film you are trying to achieve. So if you are achieving good results with less of a flow, stick to that flow. I was actually achieving fantastic results at about 750 mils per minute. So it's not a hard, fast number. Just work with the numbers that you've got and you'll generally get a good result even at lower flow rates. You really don't want the flow rate to be too high and to have pooling in the system, because that's when you're going to come across problems like pythium or root rot. Now, to make it all nice and neat, I'm just going to zip tie our irrigation lines in place. So I'm putting in a master tap so I can turn the whole system off with one turn. And I'm going to run this 19 millimeter tubing into 4 13 millimeter tubing, each with their own tap as well. So now we're just going to drill in holes just slightly smaller than these will fit through. I'm trying to achieve a tight fit here so they don't fall out. Just behind the first hole. So this is a 10 millimeter drill bit. I'm just going to widen that hole. I'm going to need a Christmas tree bit. So this is a Christmas tree bit. It's ugly. No, not happy with it. I'm changing the design. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move this whole assembly back and use this to support all of the piping on the end, at the very end. And I'm going to dig it into the ground and use this as the end support for these channels. Now we're going to level the system so that it's level across, but we're going to slope the system as well. So the slope is going to be anything greater than 3%. You can have fall as steep as you like, but you really want greater than 3% slope because you don't want pooling in the system. All right, so in a round pipe system, getting level across this way isn't really necessary. But in a square pipe system, because the bottom of the pipe is flat, you don't want it on a lean because it'll just cause it to go to one side of the system and defeat the purpose. So just go across and level your system and we're good to go. That makes me much happier. All right, now I'm just gonna run flex tube up to the holes that we've made. Nice. Before we put them in though, slice the end like so, so that if it goes flush against the pipe, it won't stop the flow. And you can see here how it won't block even if it's flush against the pipe. And I'm just leaving this one free, and I'll add some hose to it if I want to add in another channel. Now, I'm not saying that these tube sizes are the only sizes that you should go with. In my first build, I had 2 4 millimeter pipes and that worked absolutely fine. It's dependent on the flow you want to achieve. I'm probably going to aim for somewhere between that 750 and 1 liter per minute for this system, but that number is fluid. I'll be adjusting that as I see fit. And the taps on the pipes allow me to do that, not just across the system, but individually on each channel. All right, we're looking pretty good. Now, let's turn on the pump and see how it runs. So I get a lot of questions about this box. This is an IP rated electrical box, which allows me to have all of my electrical connections outside. So as you can see, we've got a nice flow rate and I'm getting some really nice aeration in that nutrient reservoir. I will have to do something about that light that's leaking in. I'll just put up some panda film behind that, I think. And that's the flow rate up this end. And that is adjustable because of these taps. So you can have that as little or as much as you like. And because of the size of these pipes, it's very unlikely that they're gonna clog up with anything. I mean, I say that, just wait for the video. And if I like, I can adjust all of them at once by turning this master tap. One thing that I foresee maybe becoming an issue is light penetration through this section of open reservoir. So I'm gonna come up with a solution for that. I may not even need a solution for it. I'll just see how it goes. All right, so it's time to add in our hydroponic nutrient. The nutrient that I'm using at the moment is the Diamond Special Tea. The reason I'm using it is because it is so cheap. Not only is it cheap, but it's really good quality. So it's $63 for the special tea and $19 for the nitro cal. Now, the rate that you apply the Diamond Special Tea is 1 gram per liter. And in addition to the Diamond Special Tea, you need to use the Nitro Cal, which is also 1 gram per liter. Now, because this nutrient actually turns out perfect with my water pH-wise, I don't have to adjust my pH. But the ideal way to adjust your pH is to adjust it already knowing how much the nutrient changes the pH of your water. So you have to test this yourself. You will get the hang of it over a while, and you need to pH balance the water before you put the nutrient in. That's the best way to do it. You can adjust it afterwards, but the problem with adjusting your pH afterwards is that as you add the pH adjuster, it will cause small areas of high and low pH that might affect the nutrient and cause it to fall out of solution. You can mediate this by adding it into a bucket of water first and then adding the bucket in if you've already added your nutrient. Okay, so to mix the nutrient, you can just add it straight in the res. It's not the ideal way to add it in. I've done it before and it works, but you can end up with undissolved nutrient. This is the proper way. So you weigh up your nutrient to how much you need. So 1 gram per liter for this specific nutrient. It may be different for your nutrient. It's just a dry nutrient. Here is the diamond tea part. Here is the calcium nitrate part. And we're just going to add those straight into separate hot water buckets because you don't want these interacting with each other when they're more concentrated than the final strength. So we'll just add these in and mix them in. This is just a brew stirrer. You can get these from homebrew stores, or you can just use a spoon. So we'll just get that nice and dissolved. So you can see here why I'm using a black bucket. It's because you can see when the nutrient's fully dissolved. Keep mixing until you get it completely in solution. Okay, once you're happy and the nutrients are completely dissolved within your hot water solution, we can just add them straight into the reservoir. In it goes. We'll just give that a bit of a mix. And once you're happy that it's evenly dispersed throughout the res, we'll add the second in. We'll give that a bit of a stir as well. Now we're going to test the EC, which is the strength of the nutrient solution. EC stands for electrical conductivity, and it allows us to determine how much hydroponic nutrient is in the solution. We're also gonna test the pH, which is the acidity or the free ions within the solution. Instead of using this, which is quite an expensive piece of equipment, you can use a hydroponic pH test kit, which costs about $20. And instead of this, which is also quite an expensive piece of equipment, you can purchase a cheap knockoff on eBay for fairly cheap as well. I'll put Amazon and eBay links in the description for this. It's waterproof, just like the Truncheon, and it gives a fairly accurate reading. Versions of these are also available online, cheap, and I'll leave a link in the description for those as well. So the EC is 2.6, which is way too high. I'm gonna need to bring that down. So all I'm gonna do now is add some water to this and get that down to about 1.5 for lettuce. I'm happy with that. We're just above 1.6. Now we can test the pH. All right, so I've got a pH of 6.2, which is perfect. And I didn't adjust that at all. So this nutrient works really well with my water. So our system's built, the pump's running, the nutrients in the reservoir. We're ready to start gardening. Let's get some plants in her. So these seedlings are probably a little more advanced than you need them to be. And I've got a mixture here of leafy greens and fruiting plants. I'm not gonna put the fruiting plants into this system. I'm gonna leave them for future videos. This is the part where we get to see the utility in having a multimedia system. So we can use not only Jiffy peat pellets, but rock wool cubes, which will sit flat against the bottom of the channel, as well as net cups, which will sit in the channel holes. And as you can see here, the nutrient film is just touching the bottom of that net cup. So you could even start seeds within this system with a medium like cocoa perlite, and that would be absolutely fine because it will wick up from below. And pucks, which we can use for plants that we don't have any media around. So you can use the puck propagation system in this system. Now, the size of these pucks is slightly too large for these holes because they're actually made for a 64 millimeter hole saw. However, we can just adapt the puck size to the system. So in the video where I showed you how to make your own pucks for planting into a hydroponic system, you will just take your key piece and make it to this 2-inch measurement. So to plant these seedlings, all you do is you take your ready seedling, and by now it's developed roots penetrating through whatever media that you're propagating in, and you pop it in your system. Now these rock wool cubes were cut without knowing what they're being used for. So I would just, in the future, cut these cubes so that I know that they fit into the 2-inch hole. Let's plant the rest. And as you can see, we can also use Jiffy pellets. So we just pop that in. And will you look at that result? I'm really happy with this system, and I'm really looking forward to sharing with you all the produce that I produce. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Hoochos. Like and subscribe for more, and I'll see you next time. Happy hydroponicking.